Hello everyone, welcome to The Point of View by Harbinger Systems. My name is Jomi John and I'm the host of the series where we answer some of the most important questions and the most frequently asked questions actually in HR tech, work tech and many of their adjacencies based upon our own research and experience in these areas. In today's Point of View, we will talk about technology trends of 2021 and not just any technology trends, but those that will impact HR tech and also all those companies that build technology products in this area and also eventually those enterprises that will use these products. So to help us in this discussion, let me invite my co-host Mahesh Kumar, who has architected many such products in HR tech, starting from processes from recruit till retire. And we will both be chatting up with Prachi Kulkarni, who is our expert consultant. And she herself has over 2 decades of experience in providing technology consulting to many companies all across the globe. A very warm welcome to you both, Prachi and Mahesh.
Thanks, Jomi.
Thank you, Jomi. And for our viewers, Jomi also has a decade of experience in both consulting and talking to the customer about their problems. And you know what? I think Jomi just loves talking about problems.
That's not true. I actually just love talking. And I think that's the reason we're here. And I'm not going to stop you from doing that. And the reason I've pulled you in is because I've been reading a lot about, all these technology trends, and there's tons of research available out there for us. However, it's really difficult for someone to, comprehend those and understand how they could apply those technology trends into their own technology roadmaps. So I'm sure Prachi and Mahesh, you've got your own list of trends. Do you want to begin by that?
Sure, Jomi. Prachi, I think we're discussing about this recently too, right? So do you want to go first and then probably I'll chime in?
Yeah, sure. So Mahesh, like we were discussing, Gartner has recently published a list of technology trends, and I thought that this will be very useful for our discussion here. So I have shortlisted 5 trends and we'll go one by one. The first one in my list is total experience. Now we have seen so far how businesses use the multi-experience where different communication channels and modalities are used to connect with customers and end users. Now we are going to go one step further where now businesses will need to look at the designing a more unified experience for all stakeholders. It can be employees, it can be customers, it can be teams with these multiple communication channels. In Harbinger, we see this trend getting followed by multiple customers, and I will be happy to give you an example where in one case, the business created a hiring platform, a job marketplace, multiple mobile applications for candidates as well as employers where interviews could be connected and they could interact and all that. So essentially all the stakeholders were connected for a cohesive experience. The vendors, the employers, the candidates all could connect using the unified communication. This resulted in enhanced user experience, enhanced customer satisfaction. Not only that, it also provided us tons of data about the communication methodologies, the behavior for both internal and external stakeholders. And I guess this was very valuable.
I completely agree, Prachi. I think some of my observations are the early adopters here are the productivity and collaboration tool providers from emerging work tech ecosystem. Now, if you look closely, the collaboration tools like Microsoft Teams, they are providing different mechanisms such as conversational interface or custom application development support or even tab views, which is as simple as to enable integration with different productivity and HR applications. So the unified user experience can be delivered to everybody who is interacting with these platforms. And if you like even look 2 days back, I think the recent acquisition of Slack platform by Salesforce just validates this trend even further.
Yes.
Great. So Prachi, what's the next trend?
Okay, the second thing I would like to talk about is the hyper automation. Now, this trend is an extension, an enhancement of the process automation trend that we already know. We know various tools and techniques, say the remote process automation or the event-driven programming, which was used to integrate processes. But this was done so far as and when needed, on needed basis essentially. And these processes were not talking to each other. Now with hyperautomation, what we are, I mean, not necessarily talking to each other, but with hyperautomation, what we are looking at is end-to-end automation, where the processes will exchange information via integrations and connectors and all that. And so there will be an easy access of data and obviously insights all throughout the business portal.
And I think, Prachi, I would like to add here more information from the HR tech side of it. And as you mentioned about the processes, I think every HR application has these workflow engines at its core, which essentially helps HR in automating different workflows and processes that they use in their day-to-day life. And as you mentioned, I mean, in the current ecosystem, a typical hiring process in the ATS stops right after releasing the offer to the candidate most of the time. And the subsequent workflows for onboarding or subsequent updates in the HRIS and other platforms are executed independently. I think that's where going forward, we'll see use of RPA, which also known as robotic process automation, or similar techniques that would be used to enable connection between these workflows across different HR applications, which essentially is nothing but very related to hyperautomation concept you just talked about.
Right.
So, Prachi, what's the next one?
Okay. So the next one we would like to talk about is the distributed cloud. Mm-hmm. Now, the pandemic of 2020, we all know that it enabled remote working. I mean, the businesses had to enable the remote working, work from anywhere, anywhere operations, as we called it. But the majority, the biggest supporter of all this was the distributed cloud. Mm-hmm. Essentially, since people were working from everywhere, the backbone of the anywhere working, the cloud, where we could have data and applications at different geographical locations, but control them centrally, is something. The trend helped us a lot. It provided two benefits, obviously the remote availability, but the second one was the cost. You know, so even though there are the geographical separation, let people connect to the cloud instance, which is closer to them. And in many cases, that cloud instance was available in locations which are economically efficient for the cloud availability. So essentially, all this, the distributed cloud helped us a lot. Add to that, the total experience trend, where with their unified communication strategy, and then this helped us a lot in the anywhere availability, anywhere operations availability.
Okay, I'm just going to quickly jump in and steal Mahesh Kumar's use case moment out here. But in HR tech as well, I've been observing that the use of distributed cloud also helps with certain compliances, such as GDPR, where data separation is a key requirement. And as more and more HR apps get hosted on the cloud, it is looked upon as a solution also to handle certain data separation and even access requirements for that matter. I think this is going to become mainstream soon, and it will help in the overall adoption of cloud for even regular HR applications.
Yes, I completely agree. And now I'm going to take us all to the one trend which everyone loves talking about, that is the AI engineering. The AI and machine learning has been around for a while, but as we know, it is usually built as an afterthought. The platform stabilizes and then we start thinking about the AI. But the real benefit of AI is it could be harnessed. We start thinking about the AI right from the design stage, okay? So to give you some examples, if we include the AI right from the DevOps, it will help the teams to test the code, the release and monitor the software development more efficiently. Or maybe another trend is the augmented analysis. Now, the first one, we talked about the software development process, AI in that. The second one, the augmented analysis example, is where the machine learning and natural language processing is coupled together so that the repetitive operations which are there in the HR tech softwares, they could be easily automated. Mm-hmm. And then employee data could be analyzed, gathered and analyzed and stored for automated insights. Okay, so that's one benefit of having the AI engineered earlier on.
Yeah, and I think, Prashant, talking about the employee data and its use for AI, I think there's an additional element that is now getting considered is the ethical AI. Because, I mean, frequently it is observed that the training data and the subsequent data model that could potentially carry different kinds of biases, be it about geography, ethnic biases, or even gender biases. So that's where in coming years we'll see some of the initiatives getting defined and implemented, where the methods will be used to remove such biases right at the data layer. So when you implement your assisted AI or different models, it doesn't get carried into that.
Great. And I think we have time for just one tiny trend, if Prachi, you want to quickly touch on that.
Yes. Yes, I know. So the last one I want to talk about is the people analytics. Mm-hmm. Now, we know the HR analytics, HR generates a lot of data which could be analyzed further. But now what we are seeing this year, that the people data needs to be connected with the operational or locational based data. For example, we can have the biometric and the behavioral data along with people data so that we can analyze the productivity. Or maybe the real-time analysis. I mean, we need not have a separate module for data analysis. We can embed the analytics in the business model, the behavioral analytics in the business model, and we can have the real-time predictions, okay? So I have explained, I know you mentioned about the small time, the time running out. So I have explained more details and use cases in the blog. So in case you want to take a look at it, feel free to take a look at it.
And Jumi, one more quick addition here. I think we did some of the data analysis for a company where we use candidate data collected during background checks to predict his or her performance post-joining.
Great. And I'm just intrigued by one big question is, why are you so interested in use cases?
You got me, Jumi. I think, to be honest, this time of the year, I mean, not just this year, but every year our inbox gets flooded with emails referring to trends to watch out for incoming year, right? And I think all of us really appreciate everyone out there who puts in a lot of hard work to come up with this kind of research. Mm-hmm. But when we talk to our customers about these trends, their first response to this is, okay, can you help us understand how does this really matter to my product? And that's where, in my opinion, like sort of matching these trends with the actual use cases helps us draw the complete picture.
Absolutely. And I think this discussion has been great. And I think your Prachi, your list of trends that you have made are super, super crisp and also very important. Now, I think we have a question coming up from our live audience. Let me just quickly get that up.
Okay.
The question is for you, Prachi, and it reads, what is your recommendation for someone who would like to take these trends to their actual implementations?
When I think about the trends, like I kept on saying, this is an extension of the technology or the architectural trends that we already have, okay? But the overarching picture, the important message from these trends this year is that define a strategy which connects all the pieces. I mean, if you consider hyper automation, the processes or the workflows were getting connected. If you consider total experience, the stakeholders were getting connected, better connected for a cohesive experience. So trying to see how the pieces connect so that we will have easy access of data and then further analytics and further operational, better operational efficiency. This bigger picture is something that you should keep in mind when implementing the trends.
Absolutely. And I think I wouldn't have said it better. I think what Prachi and Mahesh and all of us here want to convey the same is that it is important to have these trends to guide your technology roadmap from where it is currently and steer it intelligently in a way, especially in the coming years, so that you have a more connected and integrated HR technology ecosystem. I think that's what is coming out from all these trends. And we have tons of resources that can guide you if this is something that you are interested in knowing about or something that you are trying out yourself. Plus, I think we would be publishing a blog soon, which Prachi herself has written, which will give you the details of the research that we have done on this topic. And if you have any questions, feel free to direct them to consulting@harbingergroup.com, or you could also leave us a comment below and we'll be more than happy to answer your questions as soon as possible. Thank you for listening in and a very big thank you to you, Prachi, and to you, Mahesh, for collating all this research and making it applicable to our audiences here. And just a quick note for our audiences, if you're interested in many of our point of view sessions that we would be lining up, please do feel free to let us know what you are interested in knowing about, and also what you would like to what you liked or disliked in any of our point of view sessions, and follow us on our social media handles so you are regularly updated about the same. Thanks for listening in, and I hope you enjoyed listening to the session as much as we enjoyed making this for you. Thank you so much, and stay safe and stay tuned.
Thank you.